The next homework problem was log in, which generated a form like this, and it had a couple properties. If you typed in a name that doesn't exist and an invalid password and click submit, you get an error message. But if you type in a name that does exist and a valid password, you get redirected to that same welcome page. So let's talk about the code that makes this work. It's actually going to be 90% of the code we just saw for user registration, so it should be pretty quick. Okay, so we have slash login, which goes to the login handler. Let's look at that. Okay, so if you go to get, it does login form.html. I'm sure you can imagine what that looks like. It's just a basic form, you know, with the one error field and fields for username and password. Nothing magical there. We get the request. Out of the request, we get the username and the password. Then what we do is we call this function login on the user object. And we'll go look at that in a sec. Basically, it returns the user if this is a valid username and password combination, and none if it's not. So if you, we call the login function, which we'll look at also in a sec, which sets the cookie, just like it does for register. You can actually see the register code up here. We log in the user, and we redirect to the welcome page. If it's not, if there is no you, we re-render the form with an error message that says invalid login. Okay, so let's look at this login function here on the user object, and then the login function here on the blog handler. And I realize I probably could have named those a little better, so they're not quite so confusing. But these are actually different functions, even though they have the same name. So first is the user object. Okay, so here's the user object, and it has a class method called login. So we can say user.login. And what this does is it says class by name, which just refers to itself. It refers to the user class. So it's actually going to call this function. The reason we say class by name here and not user by name is so that we can overwrite this function later. And you can actually see I haven't been consistent about that. This should really be class. All of these should be CLS and not uppercase user. Since I haven't inherited this class, it's not a big deal, but that's a bug waiting to happen. So, and you know, now you get to see how bugs happen in the real world. So we call by name, which calls this function by name, which looks for a user of that name. And if it exists and it's a valid password, which is that function, you know, the quiz function we wrote before, you know, if the name and password entered in match the password hash from that object with that name in the database, we return the user. So that's that first login function that basically checks to see, is this name and password combination valid? And if it is, we go up here to our handler, and we call this login function. Remember down before we called self.login? Well, this is what it refers to, is this function here. And all this function does is it sets a secure cookie, user ID, and it equals the user's ID. And this is how you get the user's ID in the App Engine data store. Now, remember, on our next request to the welcome page, we're going to call initialize, as every request calls initialize. And what this does is it reads a secure cookie called user ID. And if that is valid, it sets self.user to that user. And so that's how login works. Let's move on to logout.